Here we have the sea oxeye, which also has all kinds of other names. Got some bees on there. Honey bees are happy. The sea oxeye likes brackish water, and while it's considered an edible, I think that's stretching the point a bit. Here's a better example of it here. It's edible raw, it's edible cooked, but I don't know, strikes me as something you have to be eating a lot as a kid to like, or grow up with it, or use it sparingly. It's pretty bitter and it's pretty strong, but it is edible, and you can see where it likes to grow. This is the Peace River in Port Charlotte, and it's brackish water. And also there we got some egrets and some mallards. In fact, one time I rescued a mallard here that was suffering from red tide and took it home with me and didn't eat it. I actually rehabbed it and let it go in one of our little local ponds. But anyway. Again, it's pretty easy to identify. There's two species in the rest of the video. I'll tell you how to separate them. And you can taste the leaves if you like them. If you like to eat them, you're more than welcome to. Yeah, they're difficult to get around, but they're appreciated in the islands. Sea oxeye. Borrichia frutescens. Hello there, I'm Green Dean, and thanks for joining me on my 153rd video, this time about an edible species you may not have heard of, the sea oxeye or Borrichia frutescens. I see this plant regularly when I'm near the ocean or brackish water, like a river where the river and the ocean meet. Let's go look at it some more. Get a better look here. Sea daisies, all kinds of different names, but there they are. One headache locally is that there are two species that look similar and they hybridize. The sea oxeye, which is Borrichia frutescens, and the seaside tansy, which is Borrichia aborescens. Fortunately for us, Daniel Austin, who is a professor of botany, he comes to our rescue. He says, you squeeze the blossoms gently. If you feel prickles, it's the frutescens. If not, it's the aborescens, although not everybody agrees with that assessment, because they might be testing hybrids too. There are also some leaf possibilities, colors also. The frutescens tends to be silvery and the aborescens tends to be green, but they can mix and match. Interestingly, only the frutescens is mentioned as an edible in Cornucopia 2, which is a standard reference, but other sources say both are actually edible. This patch of green used to be US 1. And we're a few miles south of Daytona Beach, which is about 200 miles further north of where the rest of the video was shot. In fact, the last time I was here, this water was rising because of a hurricane off the shore, and it was knee deep here and getting deeper. And we were here to see this species right here. This is our local goji berry, which is what, Lycidium carolinianum or something like that. And you can see it's intensely in blossom. But we're not here today to see that. We're here today to see this. Borrichia frutescens. Yep. And if we squeeze it, oh yeah, you can feel little prickles there. You know, that's definitely the Borrichia. So right next to it, we've got the Lycidium, and here we've got the Borrichia. And more Lycidium in fruit, or trying to in blossom. Yeah. It's actually related to tomatoes. You wouldn't think that, but it is. And of course, US 1, I think because of all the water here, is actually several hundred feet west now. So it's a nice little trail, but all through here, there's some toxic invasive Brazilian pepper. So we've got all kinds of Lycidium right here. I mean, the goji berries right here, right next to this, these stools. But again, we're here for some of these. Also notice when it gets older, it gets dark in the center, and then it will actually lose its petals. See that? And you can just feel the seeds. Yeah. Might take some of those home with me. There's the seeds. Yeah. Don't be surprised if you don't find these common names attached to your plant, because there's a lot of common names. Among them, Jamaican samphire, sea bush, bussy seaside tansy, sea marigold, beach carnation, that's a bit strange, and oxeye daisy. And the truth is, the botanical names don't help us much either. As I mentioned, frutescens means shrub-like, and aborescens, it only grows about a yard high, and aborescens means tree-like, but it only grows to about 5 feet. And the genus name doesn't help us either, because it was named for a Danish physician named Ole Borch, who died about 333 years ago. He had several professorships, including one in botany and science at the University of Copenhagen. But frutescens means shrub size. And so this particular species doesn't usually get much more than 3 feet high, a yard high. And aborescens, the other species, it means tree-like, and only gets about 5 feet high. And this one here has silverish leaves, and the other one has kind of green leaves, but they can interbreed and hybridize and go all kinds of ways, so that's kind of hard to sort that out depending upon where you are. Find them. Here's some that have gone to seed. You can almost see the little spikes on the end of the seeds. See them? You can eat the leaves raw or cook them. Young and tender is better best if you're going to go eating them raw. Actually, young and tender is better if you're going to cook them as well. Maybe you can use them for a spice or a flavoring, if sparingly, because they do have a bitter aftertaste to them. Raw, they're usually used in salads with a lot of vinegar. Nutritionally, we know they have some magnesium because that comes with the chlorophyll molecule, and they've also been used to treat scurvy, so there's some vitamin C or ascorbic acid. And now, let's go do a taste test. more like a taste marathon. Well, we're inside now with some sea oxeye. Borrichia frutescens, and I've got some apple cider vinegar here, balsamic vinegar here, and to clean my palate, in between, some scotch. So let's try a leaf. Yeah, because they're supposed to go well with vinegar. Slightly on the bitter side. And it wasn't bad. Let's try it here. The younger leaf goes with balsamic vinegar a lot better. But it is on the bitter side. I think the first person who ate this had to be really hungry. But there it is. Yeah. Leaves can be, they can be elliptical, oblong, squarish, curl a lot, stuff like that. And of course, here again is there's the seeds. And if you press the seed head, you can feel the sharp little seeds in there. Yeah. So I need to clean the palate here. Put it back. Let's give another one a try here. I think young and tender is going to be much, much more than what we want. Yeah. Yeah. Young and tender, the problem is it tastes good, and then there's a back flavor that's really on the bitter side. Yeah. So in small amounts in a salad, I think it'd be fine. Or maybe cooked, I might try that. That's a possibility. We'll give that a shot. I did an experiment here. Well, not so much experiment, but I actually cooked the leaves. I boiled them for quite a while. and they are more palatable cooked. Actually, they're mild in flavor, but they still have a good amount of bitterness as an aftertaste. So if you like bitter, that'd be the way to go. They lose, when you boil them, they lose that initial bitter punch, resinous flavor that they have when they're raw. They're much nicer. They could be mixed in with other things. I could see tossing them into a soup or a stew or something like that, or eating them this way if you happen to like bitter. What I also did was I fried some in coconut oil, and they actually come out pretty good. Initial flavor is quite good, but you know, there's a latent bitterness there. Not as strong. Well, the bitterness when they're fried is it's not as apparent. It doesn't hit you immediately. When you eat a raw leaf, man, the bitterness is right there immediately. On the boiled leaf, it's less. On the fried leaf, the bitterness is almost gone until a few seconds later, and then it seeps in a little bit on the hard side. So they actually taste the best when you cook them, fry them, but the bitterness is a bit stronger there. It's just more latent. Whereas the bitterness when you boil them, they're actually more like a green here, but there is a mild bitterness to them. So you got two different ways here.
I am not an herbalist. I have enough responsibility just as a forager without being an herbalist and prescribing people plants. That said, a decoction of the plant has been used for colds, coughs, whooping coughs, and back pain. I'm not quite sure how that last one fits in. And also, it's been used to, quote, keep the insides cool, unquote. Whatever that means as well. A leaf tea has been used to treat the fish poison ciguatera. So, pretty popular for that, leaf tea. When you cook the leaves, the water's green. I presume that is the leaf tea. Here in Eat the Weeds, we itemize, and so let's itemize our Borrichia frutescens, sea oxeye, and we start with identification. As you've seen in the videos, the stems tend to be erect. A single blossom on the end, usually of the main branch or side branch. The rays of the flowers are yellow, and the central disc is a bit darker, and particularly when it goes to seed. When the seeds mature, the yellow rays drop off, and the central disc becomes much dark and hard, and the seeds are sharp to the point. If you grab the blossom too quickly or too hard, you'll actually poke your fingers. Don't want to do that. Time of year. It flowers from late spring to early fall, actually maybe some places year-round, and they attract butterflies. Of course, you can eat the leaves anytime, and younger is always better. Environment. It is found in salt marshes and along dunes, at the rack line or in brackish locations. If covered by the rack line, it actually recovers quite quickly. Sea oxeye grows on the coast from Virginia to the Yucatan Peninsula and also inland along the Rio Grande Valley. It's also found in the Florida Keys and had been introduced to Bermuda, the Bahamas, and Cuba. In fact, I'm from New England, I want to say Cuba. In fact, I think they have the hybrid species is more common in Cuba. Method of preparation. As already mentioned, leaves cooked or raw. Cooking changes the flavor some and moderates the bitterness, but does not eliminate it. It always has some bitterness to it, which is really quite pronounced when it's fresh. In fact, it's bitter and quite aromatic, and then if you cook it, the bitterness moderates a lot, but it's always there. And if you fry them, it actually has a nice flavor, and the bitterness holds off and then gives you a little bit of kick. So there's two or three different ways to do that, but they're always on the bitter side. I want to thank you for joining me here in my 153rd video, this time about the sea oxeye Borrichia frutescens. Until next time, this is Green Dean saying I want you to live green, think green, eat green too, and sometimes that includes a strong flavored, almost always bitter, beach plant. Toodles.